Keep it going for the silent 5 minutes of Jim Boja tuning show. We get around, we joke around, it's fun, we have a good time.
We don't have
these guys you are familiar with, I think. Somewhere in the middle of organizing a cruise that has in the middle of it a music festival on land in Mexico. They also managed to host many events and create many events, and also sing and play in the middle of many events, and also they are fine singer-songwriters as well in their own right, and performers, as you are about to be reminded. Ladies and gentlemen, your friends and mine, Paul and Storm! We're your friends and his. Goddamn guitar pedals at my feet.
Friendship.
Alright, simmer down, nerds. I haven't opened the comments yet. How you doing there, Storm?
Pretty darn good. How are you?
Tonight you are the Velvet Hammer.
Yeah, I got the wrong memo.
We turn off the snares.
I thought tonight was formal night.
Every night formal night.
This is my formal t-shirt because it's got buttons in the front.
Gotta say, it's doing it for me.
Thank you. This is my formal t-shirt, is my Joe Cocker cover band. I don't know.
Sure.
I saw a video of him performing in a t-shirt once, so it worked for me.
Only person to ever do that.
Yep. You know, when you think of t-shirts, you think of British songster Joe Cocker.
MC Frontline.
But enough of our selling of t-shirts thanks to the U.S. Cotton Council's generous donation. Jonathan mentioned occasionally we do sing songs. Occasionally we do write songs. This particular song is not new. In fact, it is well over 5, maybe 6 years old at this point, but it is still 98% relevant.
So why bother writing new songs?
We shall continue to sing it while it remains relevant. It goes out from our deep, cold, nerdy hearts to your big, warm, nerdy hearts. Start the song!
George R. R. Martin, please write and write faster. You're not going to get any younger, you know. Winter is coming, I'm growing impatient, and you still got 2 whole damn books left to go. So write, George, write like the wind.
I curse the day that my friend ever loaned me an old dog-eared paperback called Game of Thrones. How could I know that this seed would grow into an addiction that held me right down to my bones? Now 5 books later, I lurk with the masses, indignant, entitled, and waiting for word that the Great Bearded Glacier has finally published 900 more pages of crack for the nerds. Why does every new verse of your song keep taking you so goddamn long? George R. R. Martin, please write and write faster. Please give us boiled leather and sigils and steel. We need our allotment of incest and intrigue and 6-page descriptions of every last meal. So write, George, write like the wind. Took 5 years to chronicle Narnia. Tolkien had 12 years and Rowling took 10. Lucas spent nearly 3 decades on Star Wars, and we all know how that one turned out in the end.
You're not our bitch and you're not a machine, and we don't mean to dictate how you spend your days. But please bear in mind, in the time that you've had, William Shakespeare turned out 35 friggin' plays. And if you keep writing so slow, you'll hold up the HBO show.
George R. R. Martin, please write and write faster, cause we won't stop whining until we're appeased. Crap out the chapters, and George, while you're at it, stop killing our favorite characters, please. And write, George, write.
Like the wind.
George R. R. Martin, please write and write faster. Like before you are dead, George, please write like the wind. So easy to make us stop singing that song, George. So easy. Well, now, you know how I said that song is like 98% accurate at this point, or still relevant? Of course, we wrote it when we thought that they might actually hold up the HBO show.
No, nothing is going to stop that train of commerce.
And the other part, spoilers, is the whole bit about killing our favorite characters, because at this point, we've got pretty much who we're going to get, especially Jon Snow, who I believe is now the Rasputin of the Game of Thrones universe. Spoilers, they try to kill Jon Snow a lot.
Also, spoiler, Rasputin is also dead. Too soon?
Jesus, I missed the Google alert.
We're all running from the teletypes.
Is Rasputin Abe Vigoda?
They exist in the same state.
Yes, they both are. Rasputin is the Schrodinger's Abe Vigoda. They're both alive and dead. Fuck it.
This metaphor has eaten itself.
Sorry, you surprised me with an actual relevant question to the next song, as opposed to just more bits, and I was completely taken aback.
Just taking a stock of every person who's ever died.
Some water didn't just go down my windpipe, but I believe there is some third, as yet undiscovered pipe that went down.
Pablo necesita más agua, por favor.
Show off.
Just trying to help you.
Yeah, I think that's right. Wow, let's all watch this. Because nobody's paying attention to us at this point. Please don't die, please don't fall. There we go. I was going to say, we paid for all these lights. I don't care that it's still daytime out. Let's get all these lights on. I want these shit spinning no matter what's happening. Thank you for not dying, sir.